had my first fight in Lincoln, Nebraska. A smoker, they call him. And they were looking for somebody to fight me because nobody knew who I was. But they found some guy who had some experience. He was about 3 inches taller than I was. I thought, oh my God, what have I got myself into? But I ended up knocking him out in the first round. And my first four professional fights started off with four rounders, but they would end in one round. I had about 18 knockouts out of 29 fights. In any given night, I can knock a person out, you know, it just depends. People kind of were leery because they never knew, you know, if I was going to, you know, take somebody distance or just, you know, knock them out. Had the opportunity to go to London, fight the British and Bright Heavyweight Champion, knocked him out in the third round, and I thought my career was really going to take off. Didn't have good management probably at the time, and most of the trainers and managers was afraid to let their fighters fight me because, hey, you know, here's a guy that's a no-name from Omaha, Nebraska that probably could knock you out. And so they just kind of backed away from that, and I couldn't get into fights and didn't have a job, wasn't working, and that led to some other things. I ended up finding myself getting in trouble. Someone said, if you don't know your purpose, somebody will give you theirs. And I was listening to some other advice and ended up committing a robbery, getting sentenced to the men's reformatory. Did 2.5 years, was released, and worked in nightclubs and discos, been a bouncer because of my boxing skills. And that's where the Lord found me. And now I'm back in jail, taking the gospel and the good news to men and women who, as the same as I was, had lost all hope and had no purpose in life. My prison number was 30398. Sometimes I forget my phone number, but I don't forget my prison number. When I see them come in, I see them come in with no hope, hollow eyes, blank look on their face, most of them in despair. And after going through our program, going through the classes, we see the light come on. They have purpose now. And so they find that in God. They find it in a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. It's really good to have a good team with you, men and women who come along beside you, chaplains and volunteers who really have a heart for the lost souls and who help lift those people up out of that miry clay, out of that darkness, out of that hopelessness, and bring a message of life, grace, and mercy, and just the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm still fighting today. Now I fight for dignity, salvation, another chance at life for these men and women. The forces of addiction, crime, sin are not going to let up, and neither can we.